One of our customers recently had us install this Fanvil video intercom system, and we were pretty impressed with how easily it worked, how well it integrated into FreePBX, and how cheap it is, right? So this kit here includes the exterior video door phone, as well as this interior video station for only $150. Now this is a great cost-effective option for an apartment or a small business, so let me show you how it works. If you weren't already aware, Crosstalk Solutions is a full voice over IP service provider, and one of the things that we do on a pretty regular basis is these video door phones. Now, I've worked with a bunch of different brands in the past, but most of them are pretty expensive. Door phones in general, though, are super cool because it allows a designated phone or group of phones to receive calls from the front door or the back door to see who's actually there on a video screen, and then you can buzz them in with a relay that's attached to the door strike. And while we've been aware of Fanvil devices for a long time, we don't typically resell their equipment, but we did have a customer who wanted us to set up this i60 video door phone. So after we got it all set up, we were pretty surprised with how easy it was to use with FreePBX and how functional it is for the price. So on this door phone, you get a 2-megapixel camera, you get a button, and you get an RFID card reader. And then on the back, it's got a relay switch that can open up an electronic or magnetic door strike. This i60 is IP65 weather resistant out of the box, but there's also like an optional rain cover mount thing that makes it IP66. And if you spend an extra few bucks, you can actually bump this up to the i60K, which is exactly like this model, but it adds a numeric keypad as well so that your employees can have codes for opening the doors rather than using RFID. This kit here also comes with the i504W indoor station, which is a 7-inch full color HD touchscreen display. It can be powered up with PoE, or you can use a regular power adapter and you can connect it to the network with Wi-Fi. And right out of the box, these two devices connect to each other very easily. And I mean, it's like a 1-minute setup process and they both start working over your local LAN. But when you don't have a PBX in the middle, the functionality is pretty limited. You can basically call from the video door phone over to the indoor station. The indoor station can trigger the relay to open the door, but really, like, that's about it. That's all the functionality you get. So when you add a SIP server in the middle, and in this case, these are both connected to a Crosstalk hosted FreePBX system, you really get a ton of extra functionality. So the first thing I did in the PBX is I set up SIP extensions for both of these devices, and then I added the SIP credentials for the FreePBX into each one of these devices. You just log into their portal and add the SIP credentials. And then they connect right up to the phone system. Now, once that was set up, it's got some pretty simple functionalities. Like when you press the button on the video door phone, it places a call to the indoor station, as you can see here. And there we've got our video. Now, if I pick it up, it'll feedback. So I'm not going to pick it up. Actually, I will pick it up. Why not? Hello?
Hello?
All right, yeah. So it does give you some feedback when they're right next to each other, obviously. Now, I will say one thing that I'm not a super huge fan of with this i60 is that the camera isn't a very wide-angle lens. So if you do get one of these things, you're going to want to mount it up a bit higher than where you would normally mount a doorbell. Otherwise, you're kind of just going to be looking at everyone's belt. When you press the button, the indoor station receives the call, and you have the option on the indoor station of triggering the relay here. So let me show you that. I'm making another call in. All right. So here I am calling in. Hey, I'm at the front door. Answer that call, and you can just hit door right there. You don't even have to answer the call. And then you hear that it triggered that relay. It's still ringing though. Now, since I'm running this through the FreePBX, we also have voicemail set up for the indoor station. So that's something you don't get if these are just direct connected to each other. Basically, it means that if someone rings the doorbell and you're not at your desk or you're not home, the person outside can leave a message. Now, it's not gonna be a video message, but at least you can receive a voicemail. So to configure the Fanvil indoor station to forward to voicemail, I logged into the interface of the station. I selected line from the left-hand menu. I toggled on call forward on no answer, and then I added *513 to the forwarding number. So star in FreePBX is the transfer code to send a call directly to voicemail, and 513 is the extension of the indoor station. But of course, you could use the voicemail box for the reception or anywhere else that you want to use. It doesn't have to go to this thing's voicemail box. Now you can also configure how many seconds the indoor station rings before it goes to voicemail. Now I've got it set to 10 seconds, but in production, that should probably be a little bit longer. You'd probably want like 20 or 30 seconds, which is about right. All right, now I'm not sure how well this is gonna come across on video, but you also may notice that the streaming quality of the indoor station stutters a bit. That's because this is on a hosted PBX up in the cloud, right? So I'm showing you that this does work pretty decently even on a cloud-hosted PBX, but if your phone system's on your local LAN, there's actually no delay in the streaming quality whatsoever. Let's take a look at that here. So it's not bad, even though it is on a hosted PBX. And we should hear it go to voicemail here.
Hello, we are not here to answer the door.
Okay, yeah, so there we go. And since the indoor station is connected to that PBX, that means you can also actually make outbound calls through this indoor station. So you can populate it with a bunch of speed dials for other businesses or the pizza place down the street, or maybe you're in a building that's got a bunch of tenants and you wanna be able to speed dial another tenant or the front reception desk or something like that. The 7-inch touchscreen has full calling capabilities, just like a regular phone extension. It can actually also do SMS, though I didn't take the time to figure out how that works. So besides outbound dialing and SMS, you get a button for monitoring the video feed of the I-60, and you have manual controls for triggering the door relay. Now let's say that you don't have or you don't want this indoor display screen. The I-60 also works on regular voice over IP video phones. So here I have the Crosstalk 280 and I just configured the I-60 to ring this phone instead, which is basically as easy as changing the extension that the I-60 dials when you press this button. So now when I press the button, it's gonna ring this phone, and then when I pick it up, I'm gonna get the H.264 video feed from the I-60, and I can talk to whomever's out there. I can also, from this phone, hit the star button to trigger the relay to let them in. All right, so let me show you that here. I'll put this phone down. There we can see this phone's ringing. I pick it up. Try not to feedback. But you can see that I have video display on this phone as well. Now, the only downside is that you don't get the video display on the phone before you pick up the call like you do with the indoor station, but it does work pretty good. I was in the process of recording this video and I mentioned that these do RFID, but I forgot to show it to you. So here I have a YubiKey. This was just something I had lying around that I know will do RFID. And if I bring it close to the scanner right here, it's gonna trigger that relay. There we go. So it was also pretty easy to set up RFID to open the door. Now the Fanvil kit also comes with licenses for a smartphone app that does a lot of what the indoor station does. I'm pretty sure that with the app you can just receive calls from the door phone and then you can trigger the relay. I didn't actually test it out, but it does come in the kit with some licenses for that app. But all in all, this is a super functional little kit for $150. And this is their entry level, like bottom of the barrel model. Fanvil does have some much higher quality models as well. And I'm sure they all work with FreePBX, very similar to what we saw here. So if you are interested in video door phones at your own location, be sure to contact us at crosstalksolutions.com. We are a full voice over IP phone system provider, and we can help with all of these little ancillary devices like door phones, paging intercom systems, loudspeakers, faxing, you name it, and we've got a solution for your business. Or if you just want to buy one of these kits here, I've got links down in the description below. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, and if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is for all of those Mitel customers out there whose phone systems are very soon gonna be end of life, and the bottom video is a list of my top 5 favorite UniFi products for 2025.